And we will continue. Reverend David Yee will read the letter from Reverend Son, the president of the Korean Church Coalition.
Thank you. Pastors from throughout the United States is here today in front of our nation's capital to be the voice for the voiceless, our suffering North Korean brothers, sisters, and especially the orphans. We are thankful to the leaders of this great country and for the support you give to the Korean people. The people of Korea have grown and prospered together with you, and we acknowledge our long history and relationship with the United States. The United States is the home of the free, but that freedom is threatened by all those who crave power over others, especially by the regime of North Korea. They make threats and posture for war because they are afraid of our freedom. They know that if the people of North Korea had the freedom that we enjoy here in America, the regime leaders would be thrown out and powerless. They know that their rule is built only from fear and ruthlessness, and they know that pressure is building around the world for their brand of evil to disappear from the face of the earth. To the leaders of North Korea, you continue to act like spoiled children, throwing childish tantrums every time you don't get what you want. You want respect and to be treated like a great power, but the truth is you are powerless. Your threats are empty and overused. You keep repeating the same tired old message, and the world is not fooled by your actions any longer. Stop this nonsense. Stop pretending you are something you are not. You talk of crushing your enemies when you cannot even feed your own people. You speak of victory while you rely on other countries for basic necessities. You are the definition of the blind leading the blind. Your threats and violent words are nothing and will gain you nothing. To the people of God, to the salt and the light of this world, stand up, be strong and courageous, and remember that we are more than conquerors. Our power comes from the ruler of the universe, and there is no end to his greatness. What are missiles compared to the hand that holds the whole world? What is a nuclear bomb compared to the power over sin and death? We already have the ultimate victory. All we need is faith. And finally, to our God Most High, hear our prayers, Lord, and set your people free. You cannot stand evil, so Lord, do not stand by while an evil regime hurts the helpless. As it says in Psalm chapter 5, for you are not a God who is pleased with wickedness. With you, evil people are not welcome. The arrogant cannot stand in your presence. You hate all who do wrong. You destroy those who tell lies, the bloodthirsty and deceitful. You, Lord, detest. But I, by your great love, can come into your house. In reverence, I bow down towards your holy temple. We are here, Lord. Use us to bring glory to your name and freedom to your people. It is our prayer that the wicked will not slip through without justice, that the wrongs of the earth will be made right. And we will join in this prayer together. May God give us the strength to fight against evil and to speak out against injustice. And may his kingdom come, his will be done, here in America and in North Korea as well.